We're going to open up in prayer before we get started. Thank you, Lord. Father, once again, we're just so honored and blessed to be in your house today. Father, once again, we just give you all the glory that you're worthy of, Lord, as we sing praises under your name. Lord, as we offer up our thanksgiving unto you, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we give you all this in your wonderful, wonderful name. Amen.
Good morning. How are you today? God is good. Welcome to Vision Church. We're going to praise the Lord this morning for everything he has done in our lives.
Desperate for you. Thank you.
Yes, he did gave it all, right? Oh, we're going to come now to our tithes and offering. It's time to worship the Lord in our offering. God is so good. When we just sang that song, Jesus gave it all. The scripture I have here is in 2 Corinthians chapter 8. It's a little, I picked a few verses, 1 through 4. We're going to go there real quick. It says, "Moreover, brethren, we make known to you the grace of God bestowed on the churches of Macedonia, that at the great trial of their affection, the abundance of their joy and their deep poverty bounded in riches of their liberty. For I bear witness that according to their ability, yes, and beyond their ability, they were freely willing, imploring us with much urgency that we would receive the gift and the fellowship of the ministering of the saints. Right here, I know you're probably wondering, what's that have to do with anything? But Paul here was trying to tell them that the church of Macedonia was a church that was in deep poverty and being very much persecuted at this time. But yet this church had an attitude of giving and of love. And he was trying to encourage them that in spite of what you are going through, the love of God is able to exceed that. So he was exploring them because he said that they freely gave, meaning they didn't have to be told to do it, they just did it. You know, when we give, not necessarily here he's talking finances, but he's talking about showing love. When we have the love of God, we give. We do what God asks us to do. And we just sang about how God just gave it all. Are we willing to do the same? I know that a lot of times, there are times where even the old widow who gave her two mites that she had, she was still willing to give it all. And she did it because she was obedient to the Lord. And I'm not saying for you to give us your last two pennies, but I'm just saying that it's just showing that it's not a sacrifice if you're doing it out of love. So that's basically what he's telling us here, that when people are hurting, it's almost like the poor people are more willing to give than those that have money. I don't know if you've ever kind of seen that, but then people would say, well, that's why they have money. Yes, they have money now, but it's not eternal. And you know what we do here now is going to be eternal if we're doing it in the love of God. So give, you know, search your heart. I know it hurts sometimes when we don't have anything, and yet it's a sacrifice. And so he's just asking them that he's hoping that this would be an encouragement to them, not so much telling them you need to give, but to do it out of the love, and just let this be an example to you that even people who are hurting, and they do it because they have the love of God in them. And I know all of y'all here, and y'all all love the Lord. So I just wanted this to be an encouragement. And I know that right now we're going through times that maybe we're hurting physically or financially or other ways, but you know what? God knows, and he's going to bless you for being obedient to him. So let that be encouraging to you, to know that that's what we're here for. You know, when we give to the church, we give to our other brothers and sisters as well that are in more need that we may be in. You know, we always say there's somebody else that can be hurting worse than you. And so we never know everybody's circumstances, and we don't, but God does. So if you want to get your offering ready, you can go ahead and bring it up, and we'll pray over it. And I'll say a blessing over it. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. It's so cute. Oh, they're just precious. Thank you, Lord. To me, that's excellent. You know, I want to just say real quick, I want to give props to our family members here, our parents. We teach our kids young to give, and that's great. I think that's awesome. So I like to see that. Thank you, Lord. Father, once again, we're just honored and to be able to give to you, Lord, and I thank you, Lord, for each one here. I pray, Lord, that I'm believing that everyone gives with a joyful heart, Lord, as we are to do, Lord, to give willingly and joyfully, and not because we feel obligated, but because we want to out of obedience to you. And so, Father, I just pray that you would bless these finances that are here, Lord, those that gave, Lord. You know their hearts and you know their circumstances. I pray that they would be met. Father, that you would give back to them, Lord, in areas of their lives where they are in need. Father, for their obedience. And again, Lord, we know that you're able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we could imagine, Lord. And Father, we put you first, Lord, in every area of our lives. And financially, Lord, I'm believing that according to your word, that if we put you first, Lord, that you would give everything else. And so, Father, I just believe, dear God, that this money will go to bless your kingdom, Father, and those that gave. And again, I just thank you for everybody here that gave. And those that couldn't but are willing to, Lord, I pray that you would just make a means for them, Lord, to have the opportunity to give, Lord, when they are not able to. You know their hearts, Father. And again, we're just grateful. And we ask all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. And I know that there is a way to give online as well. I don't know the address by memory. There it is. So if you want to give online, you go to vclockhart.com, or you can mail it at P.O. Box 1399, Lockhart, Texas, 78644. So we do take your tithings that way as well. So, awesome. So that was it for the tithing. Thank y'all so much for that. So now we're going to go over our quick announcements. We don't have many, so it's not going to take very long. And then we're going to get into the exciting word of God. Y'all ready? Man, all right, making sure I haven't lost y'all. Okay, you can come to our website at vclockhart.com for all our services on YouTube and Facebook. And until further notice, we still have our guidelines in effect. Number one, every other row will be blocked off. Two, families must sit two chairs apart from each other. And, well, from other families, not from each other. And three, practice social, unless you're mad at your spouse or something, y'all might want to sit two chairs apart. Oh, okay. Three, practice social distancing. Four, feel free to wear a mask or gloves. And five, if you feel sick, remember, we always encourage you to let us know, and we will be glad to call you and pray for you. And then we're going to have our services as usual on Wednesdays at 7 p.m., and we're still studying on how to become a water walker. So they're both in English and in Spanish. So if you want to learn English or if you want to learn Spanish, you can come to both of them and you'll get a little bit of each. And so we just encourage you to come and join us on those classes as well. And last but not least, we've been forgetting to announce that on Thursday nights, ladies, we've been getting together for a Bible study from Joyce Myers calling it Doing It Afraid. And it's been pretty good. Any of those that have been struggling with any fears of any sort, we just pray that you come and hear what the Lord has to say. And I think that's it. So we're ready for the Word of God. Thank y'all.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. How many of you all are ready to hear the Word of God this morning? I know y'all are sad. Y'all aren't seeing Pastor Kyle's handsome face up here this morning, but he's following the rules. Yesterday, he was running a little bit of fever. He had real bad allergies, and to play it safe, he said he was going to stay home and go get a test this morning just to be safe. And, of course, his wife, my daughter, and the kids, they decided to stay home, too, since they were all in one home. And so we'll just keep them in prayer that they will have a speedy recovery and that they won't have COVID. Amen? We can speak against it. Hallelujah. Well, let's pray, and then we'll get into the Word. Amen? Heavenly Father, we just thank you this morning for your Word, Father. Lord, I pray that your word this morning, Father, it's like your word says, it will not return to you void, Father. So, Lord, prepare the hearts, prepare my heart, the hearts of those receiving, Father, this morning, that this word, Lord, would be fall on good ground, Lord, and that it would edify us this morning, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord. I titled this message Transition. I didn't know what to call it exactly, but I think the transition was pretty good, because we're in a phase of transition. where 1 year has ended, another year has come in. And for me, it's been a busy time because we're closing out the business, everything that went in through December 31st, and we're starting new for January. And there's so many things are changing, not only the government that's changing, a new leader, right? But everything, all the paperwork, everything's being done different. And I had to get W-4s on all the employees and myself. And I don't know if y'all had to fill out new ones, but they're so different. It's not like anything that has been done before. You know, it doesn't ask for exemptions. It just, you have to put dollar signs in there, follow the formulas, and then have this big old chart that you have to figure out and fill out. And the guys were asking me, what do I put here, what do I put there? I said, I don't know. I haven't even done mine, but just follow it, read it, you know. So I was trying to help them, and I called the CPA, and I'm asking them, and they didn't know. They goes, you know, we really don't know how they're calculating everything, but just put, you know, whatever you're filing, married, joint, or head of household, whatever, and they're going to figure it out. Well, that's kind of scary because you don't really know. When we got our first paycheck, I noticed that I got a raise. And it's not that I got a raise, it was they didn't take out that much on taxes. And it kind of made me nervous because I don't know what's going to happen. And I think we're all in that kind of position right now. We don't know what's going to happen in this new year. You know, we've just been through a tough year, you know, a lot of people sick and all these things. But, you know, we're in a transition, and a lot of people are experiencing fear. And that's what the Bible study that we're doing, the ladies are doing on Thursday nights at 6:30. I encourage y'all to come because it's really a good teaching, and we're sharing and we're encouraging one another. But I think some people have gotten so fearful that they can't move on. They're terrified. And things are different, but the Word of God tells us that it's going to be okay. Amen? And so in that transition, you know, we just need to keep our eyes and look to God. Amen? So this morning, I'm just going to read to you. We're going to go look in the book of Joshua. So I encourage you to look at your W-4s because I was a little frightened. I said, okay, it's good. I got a raise, but what's going to happen when I have to pay the taxes and they didn't take out enough, you know? And when an administrator, when a president changes everything, you know, it takes a year before it kicks in, and then things are different, and then the next president comes in and changes everything again, you know? We don't know where we're at, so that's kind of, that's a little fearful. What is going to happen to us in the future? But we have the Lord on our side. Amen. Let's read. I'm going to read Joshua chapter 1:1-9. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spoke to Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' assistant, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise, go over this Jordan, you and all your people, to the land which I am giving to them, the children of Israel. Every place that your sole of your foot will tread upon, I have given you, as I said to Moses. From the wilderness and this Lebanon, as far as the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites and the great sea toward the going down of the sun shall be your territory. No man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will not leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and of good courage, for the people you shall divide as an inheritance the land which I swore to their fathers to give them. Only be strong and very courageous, that you may observe to do according to all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded you. Do not turn from it to the right hand or to the left, that you may prosper wherever you go. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your ways prosperous, and then you will have good success. Have I not commanded you, be strong and of good courage, do not be afraid, nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Amen. We have a promise from the Lord that he's never going to leave us or forsake us, that he will be with us. And y'all know that the book of the law is the Bible, and it has all the promises that we need. All the promises are still for us today. Amen. This is his will. You know, when you have children, you have a will drawn up so that when you're gone, you know, they know what they're going to do with your resources and whatever you have. And this is our will that the Lord left us. He left us his word, his will. This is his will. A lot of times we're saying, what is the will of God for my life? Look, read in your Bible. That's your will. It's his will for you. And we're going to look at seven promises that we can take from this scripture that we just read. And number one promise is he promised this land. In verse 3 and 4, it says, every place that the sole of your foot will tread upon, I have given you. As I said to Moses, from the wilderness of this Lebanon, as far as the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, to the great sea toward the going down of the sun, shall be your territory. The Lord has given us territory. Our territory could be where we are, our homes, everything that we have, and the Lord has created and given promises and blessings for us for 2021. We just came from a year that you know, just changed our world, the way we do things, the way, you know, we just, so many things. You know, we've lost loved ones, we've lost jobs, there's just so many things that have changed, but the Lord says that he will give you territory. Amen. All that you have to do is get up and walk in him. Like he says, just like I was with Moses, I will be with you. So the Lord is with you, so there's not anything to be afraid of. And the territory, you know, he has already given you. Everything that you'll need for 2021 has already been given. The Lord knows what was going to happen in 2020. He knew what was going to happen. He knows our needs. He knows what we're facing. He knows the problems we've been through. You know, whatever you're believing and standing for, just keep standing and believing for him, because he has already provided everything you're going to need, and it's going to be okay. You know, I know when in April when I finally stayed home for a month, and I thought, oh, I'm going to get some rest, because my son kept telling me, you need to stay home, you need to stay home. And I finally did for a month, and I ended up working a lot harder than I was, because that was the month that my mother got ill, and she was in the hospital several times in and out, and it was different. I couldn't go in there with her. But so all these things were going on, and one morning I was walking to the kitchen to get my coffee, and I walked by the back door, And the Lord arrested me, and I stopped at the door, and I was looking out at the door. It had rained that night before, and in the morning, you know, the sun was coming up, and there was a glistening in the grass, and everything looked so green and so peaceful, and I heard the voice of the Lord said, it's going to be okay. Amen? So we might be going through some terrible things right now, but the Lord, I'm telling you, is saying, it's going to be okay. Amen? So we just need to keep our eyes on the Lord. Amen. If you're waiting for a job, or you're waiting for something in your life, you're waiting, you know, you said, oh, now it's a terrible time. Maybe I'm never going to get that house that I've been praying for. Maybe I'll never get that car that I've been praying for. Or, you know, maybe my miracle's not going to come up. You know, just things are so difficult nowadays. But the Lord, if he promised you those things, they're still there. He has houses for you. He has cars for you. He has everything that you will ever need. My God says in Psalms 23, it says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In other words, anything that I want that is needed for me to survive and live, it's already been provided. Amen. It's just going to take us to walk and believe in the promises of God for our life. Amen. Don't give up on the Lord. He hasn't given up on you. Amen. And you can even go over to Deuteronomy 28 and read the blessings of obedience and the blessings of disobedience. You have blessings and curses there. And that'll encourage you, because it says there that you will have houses that you didn't build. Not sure if it's in those scriptures, but it is in the scripture that says that you will have houses that you did not build. Amen? So we thank the Lord for that. Number two, he promises protection. In verse number 5, it says, no man, amen, no man, that means no man, nobody, no man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so will I be with you. I will not leave you nor forsake you. Amen. You might be going through some hard times or problems or, you know, struggling through some things, but the Lord says that he's there with you and that no man will stand before you. Amen. And that means so when God has given you a promise, or you're struggling, or you're going through a trial or tribulation, and you have a word of God, and you've been standing on that word, and you're declaring that word, you find a scripture that has to do with your situation, and then you pray that word, and you stand on it. And this is what it's saying, you stand. You're not, don't fall away. If somebody comes up and tells you, oh, that's never going to happen, you're believing in a miracle, and you go, oh, forget it, that's never going to happen. They're looking in the natural, but you're looking in the spiritual, because that's the promise that God has given you, and you have to stand. So if somebody comes and tells you, that's not reality, you say, it's my reality. Don't ever say anything different. Don't say anything different. So you go, oh, yeah, you're right. No, you stand. That's a word from God, and he gave it to you, and you're going to stand. Amen? Amen? It's like in Ephesians 6:13, it says, wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God, that we may be able to stand in the evil day, and having done all to stand. And that means you're just going to stand your ground. You're going to stand on the word that God gave you. You're not going to believe what the people are saying or talking about. Amen? It says, when you believe God, you're like a train. Nothing can stop you. Nobody can stop you. Amen? Hallelujah. Don't let your problems or your trials hold you back. If you're full of God, the promises and his promises, no one can harm you. Amen? Thank you, Lord, for your word. And how do we do this? We just do it by determination and faith. Whatever we're standing on, we're just determined that this is the word that God gave us. This is what I'm believing. This is what the word says to me. And I'm going to stand on that. And you just get determined and get it down in your spirit, and you hold on. And when the winds and the waves come and they try to knock you down, you just hold on tight to that word. Amen? Thank you, Lord. Number 3, favor. In verse 6, it says, be strong and of good courage, for to this people you shall divide as an inheritance the land which I swore to their fathers to give them. And here, the favor of God is on you. If you're of God, his favor is on you. You're blessed to be a blessing, and you're going to be a blessing this year. You got to declare this. I'm going to be a blessing this year. I'm going to be blessed to be a blessing. Amen. Because you have the favor of God on you. Everything that happens, you know, there's some little things, and you could just say, that's the favor of God. And just declare. That happens to me all the time. You know, the other time we were in the restaurant, and we like to drink coffee. We were out having breakfast, and my husband always tells the waitress, we drink a lot of coffee. So she came and she goes, I don't know why. She said, every time I come to your table, this fresh pot of coffee, you get the first cup of this fresh pot of coffee. And I said, oh, that happens to me all the time, because that's the favor of God. Or we get the parking space right in front of Walmart. You know, we drove up the other night and with my husband, and he goes, oh, look, the front space. I said, that happens to me all the time when I come. So it's just favor, a blessing of the Lord. It's the inheritance that you have from God. Amen? Number 4, The presence of God. I did tell you that I had, there were seven promises that we took from, right, from these scriptures. Okay, number four, the presence of God. Verse 5 says, no man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so will I be with you. I will not leave you nor forsake you. Amen. We see that Moses was a criminal. He was disobedient to God, but God had mercy on him. And he hid from God. Don't hide from God because he wants to bless you. Amen. Y'all remember Moses being disobedient, and especially the last time when he was going to get water, and the Lord told him to speak to the rock and not to hit it the way he had done the first time. Y'all know the story, right? And he didn't do that because that was going to be our new covenant. Now we speak the word of God. We speak his promises, and that's what we're going to have, and that's what he was showing us. But Moses went against what God wanted him to teach the people. And he was being disobedient, and that kept him from going into the promised land. Amen. And so we know here that I had picked this scripture because Joshua here is going to go into the promised land, right? And he's going without Moses, the leader, the one that had been before the Lord. And it's a scary time for him, you know? And it says here that I'm sure that, you know, he had been with Moses for 40 years, and when he dies, that everybody was upset. It says in here that they mourned for 30 days, you know, and he was sad and maybe downcast and wondering, you know, what am I going to do? But here the Lord dispatched the scriptures that we're reading is encouragement from the Lord, because he was encouraging him that he would be with him and go into that place of an uncertainty. And, you know, something different, something maybe scary, which is we're facing, but it's all good because God is there and he already prepared for us. So 2021, he's already prepared for us and it's good. Amen. And we know that because God is there already. Amen. So, like in David in Psalms 139, 7 and 8, he says, where can I go from your spirit, or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, you are there. Sometimes people say that they can't feel the presence of the Lord, or that they can't feel that the Lord is with them, but God is always there with us. He's always with us. He'll never leave you or forsake you. That's his promise. And, you know, I heard one pastor preaching one time, and he said that he was praying for the people down the line, and one lady was praying. She goes, I can't feel God. I can't feel God, you know. And he said that the Spirit told him, he goes, to tell her right away, he goes, well, that's good. I'm glad you can't feel God, because if you could feel the magnitude of his power, of his presence, I think our bodies couldn't take it. He says, I don't think your body could take it, but he's there, right? His power is there. His presence is there. And my husband was saying, he told me, look at the palms of your hands. He goes, you see the lines are there, but can you feel them? Can you see the creases in your hands? He goes, you see them there, but can you feel them? Or your brain, you know the brain is in your head. I hope you have a brain. Shake and see it. Yeah, it's there. But you can't feel it, but it's there. Amen. And the presence of God, his spirit is in us. We might not be able to feel it sometimes, but he said he would always be with you. And I believe that, you know, because once in prayer time with the Lord, I was seeking the Lord because I was kind of thinking I didn't have the faith that I needed to keep going in the direction that the Lord wanted me to go. And in the midst of prayer, I saw this little girl standing in front of me. And as I looked at her, I realized that it was me looking back at myself. And the Lord told me, he said, from the day you accepted me as your Lord and Savior, I've been with you. You might be away from the Lord. You might have strayed away from the Lord, but he's never left you. He's always there. Amen. So he's not going to leave you. So I believe that in his word. And we need to be believers that believe the word of God. Amen. Number 5, resources. Verse 6 says, Be strong and of good courage, for to this people you shall divide as an inheritance the land which I swore to their fathers to give them. So 2021, I believe, is going to be a year of financial resources, healing, better relationships. And if you declare that, you're going to have what you say. In Mark 11:23, it says, "For assuredly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, 'Be removed and cast into the sea,' and does not doubt in his heart." Here's the problem by here that a lot of us have. We have doubt. But if you have no doubt in your heart, but believes those things he says will be done, he will have whatever he says. So this year, you need to declare over your life the promises of God. What he says, you know, that he has provided for you in the future. You've already been provided everything that is needed in your life, every situation that you're going to go through, every problem, every trial, every sickness, every loss of job, everything he's already provided. He has a job for you. He has healing in you, for you, because it's already been provided. You just have to believe it and declare it that you have it. And Psalm 91, it says that no disease, no plague shall come nigh your dwelling. This is your dwelling, and your house is your dwelling. So you have to declare that no disease is going to come on you. I know my son, I know his heart is in the right place, and he's trying to keep us healthy and safe. And he goes, "Mom, it seems like you don't believe that this COVID is dangerous or that it's real." And I said, "Son, I know it's real. It's real, but it has no authority in my body." I said, "It has no right in my body. And so I'm standing on the word of God. I know it's going to, flus or whatever tries to attack. All diseases try to attack your body. But if you stand on the word of God and his promises and believe it and don't doubt it, it's not going to get on me." Amen. Of course, we're not going to be crazy and go out there. We're going to follow the rules, you know. We're going to follow the rules, and because we have to do our part. But it has no legal right in your body. And this is interesting because my brother Richard, he had COVID last month sometime. And he was telling me that when he was sick, that he had this fever. And he said, in the midst of the fever and, you know, it just, he was a little delirious. He said that the enemy walked up to him. He said, "The devil came and he was standing in front of me as I was, you know, he was sick with fever." And he looked at him and he said that the devil was standing there all dressed nice, you know, in his, 20 style, you know, GQ with a little hat. And he goes that he was looking at him laughing. And he was laughing at him. And then Richard said that in his deliriousness, he just got confidence, and he told the enemy, he goes, "You've got to go." And he said that in the midst of his laugh, he stopped because he saw the confidence that he had when he spoke those words, that he said that the devil just lost his laugh, and he just kind of, poof, disappeared. And I said, that tells us that this disease is of the devil. He's the one sending it and attacking all of us. Amen. But God lives in us, you know, and we can fight that because he has no authority. He has no authority to be in your body. Amen. And it's not that we don't believe or see with our natural eyes, but in the spirit, we're healthy and strong. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Number 6, prosperity. Some people don't like that word, but it's a good word. Amen. In verse 7, it says, "Only be strong and very courageous, that you may absorb to do according to all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded you. Do not turn from it to the right hand or to the left, that you may prosper wherever you go." Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. So we're going to be prosperous. We're going to be strong. We're going to be courageous. In 3 John 1:2, it says, "For assuredly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, 'Be removed and cast into the sea.'" Wait, that's the wrong one. I'm reading Mark, but I put it under John 3. 3 John 1:2, it says, Beloved, I pray that you will be in health and in, Beloved, I pray that you will be in health and prosper as your soul prospers. Amen? Thank you, Lord. So as you prosper in the Word of God, you know, your soul is prospering. That's how your soul prospers. You prosper because you read the Word of God. It gets in you, and it's rooted in you so that when trials or anything comes up against you, the first thing that's going to come out of your mouth is the Word of God. Amen? And so you're going to be prosperous in the Word in your soul, so then everything else is going to fall into place. Amen? Thank you. I'm not going to trust cut and paste anymore. Number seven is guidance. Guidance, and we're going to look at verse 8. It says, this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according all that is written in it. For then you will make your ways prosperous, and then you will have good success. So the Lord is going to guide us. Amen. It says, when we keep the promises of God before us, as it says, to keep it before you and to meditate on it day and night, we allow those promises to consume our thoughts. Our words change, so we speak life instead of death. And like when we speak, when something comes out, the first thing is instead of negativity or fear or you know, discouragement, no, you're going to speak the Word of God, and you're going to speak life. No more death. Don't be speaking death. No more. Don't speak death anymore. You're going to say what God says and stand and believe in that. It influences our decisions as well. We make better decisions when we allow the Word of God to prosper us, to be in us. And then glorious things happen. Those miracles that you've been waiting on will come to pass. Amen. Those things that God has promised you will come to pass. We overcome by what Jesus did on the cross, amen, and by what we prepared to say about it. So you say what God says, amen? Thank you, Lord. So it says, you will, for then, okay, then you will make your way prosperous. When you keep the Word in front of you, when you keep it before you, when you meditate in it day and night, then, you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. Amen? And Psalms, I went through that pretty quick. In Psalm, I'll leave you with this scripture. In Psalm 9, verse 9 and 10, it says, the Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble, and those who know your name will put their trust in you. For you, Lord, have not forsaken those who seek you. Amen. So for 2021, it's going to be a great year. You have to declare it. Of course, there's going to be changes, yes. But the Lord's calling you to arise. You know, when he told Joshua to arise, you know, we were talking about it, and some would say, well, was he lying down? Was he prostrate? What was he doing that the Lord told him to arise? And I said, it might be and it might not be any of those things, but I think he was just telling, get up and go. It's time to get up and go. It might not be a position you're in, but maybe an attitude. It's time to get up and go, to face 2021 with courage and boldness, because you have been promised good things. Right, Daddy? Yeah, we've been promised good things from the Lord. Amen? And so I just encourage you to meditate on the Word so that you will be prosperous. I encourage you that this year is going to be a prosperous year for you, to just have courage. You know, the Lord is with you. If the Lord is with you, who can be against you? Right? You know, you have all the power of the kingdom living in you. Amen. So I hope this word this morning has encouraged you. You know, it was something that we had to come up really quick. And, you know, keep keep Pastor Kyle and his family in prayer. And this morning, we will have prayer up here. If anybody needs prayer, we'll, you know, if you have a specific need that you want to be prayer about, we'll pray for you up here. But right now, I'm going to dismiss our viewing audience. Thank you for being with Vision of Vision Church of Lockhart. Thank you for being with us this morning. If someone out there that is watching this has not received the Lord as their Lord and Savior, today's your day. Today's a good day, amen, to accept the Lord. And so if you want to do that, just say this quick prayer with me this morning. Say, Lord, I thank you, Father, for your word. I believe, Father, that you died on the cross for me, Lord, for my sins and my sicknesses, Father. I believe that you were raised on the third day, and you're alive and well today. And, Father, I confess that I have made you the Lord of my life. Now take my life and do something with it. I thank you, Lord, for saving me in the name of Jesus. It's that simple. It's that simple to come into the kingdom of God. And if you've made that decision, let us know. Write us. Email us. Contact us through our website. We have a book that we would like to send you to let you know the step that you just took. And welcome to the family. And now you can claim all the promises that this word says, this book of the law, that we're going to meditate on day and night, right? It's not that you're going to carry this book around with you, but you're going to read, even if you read one scripture or a little something, and just chew on it all day. Just meditate on it. Amen? Don't replace worry with meditating. Amen? Replace fear with meditating on the word. Amen? And so welcome to the family, and we'll dismiss y'all. Have a blessed day. Thank you.